Magnetic field induction due to current carrying straight conductor. Now, whenever the current is passing through a conductor, around the conductor there is a magnetic field. The strength of the magnetic field can be calculated by Ampere's circuit law and by its Savart's law. While calculating the magnetic field induction due to the current, sometimes we may use Ampere's circuit law. Sometimes we may use Biot-Savart law. Whenever the conductor is straight, right? Either by using Ampere circuit law or by using Biot-Savart's law, we can calculate the magnetic field induction. Now, what is my topic here? Magnetic field induction due to the current carrying conductor. Now, here this is called current carrying conductor. This is the current carrying conductor. Now let us consider straight current carrying conductor. Now this is called A and B. What is the current passing through this one? I is the current passing through this one. Now around this current carrying conductor, magnetic field is produced in a plane perpendicular to the current carrying conductor. Now the current carrying conductor is like this. Magnetic field is like this. Okay, na? In this case, at a particular point, maybe here. For convenience, I am taking this as the point P. Right? What is the perpendicular distance? That is D is the perpendicular distance. Right? Now, the magnetic field induction at the point P at a perpendicular distance D. What is the magnetic field induction in order to calculate? Right? Join the point P from the top end and the bottom end. Now, let us consider this is the top end. Now this is bottom end. Now this perpendicular, right? This top end makes an angle alpha. Now the bottom end is making an angle, what to say, beta. Therefore here this is called alpha. Now this is called, what to say, beta. Now this is the beta. Okay, now? Now, by using Biot-Savart law, B is equals to, right, integration of mu naught by 4 pi I dl sin theta by r square. This is the formula. Now, what is the current, what is dl, what is theta, and what is r square you want to calculate. Now, here in this case, let us consider, right, this current carrying conductor is divided into number of infinitesimal parts. Let us consider this is a portion. What is the thickness of the portion? Right? dy is the thickness of the portion. Now through this small element dy, again the current is passing, then this is called current element. Now this current element is making an angle. this current element is making an angle, what to say, this is the theta. Now this is the theta. Now here in this case, substitute the corresponding values, right? Now here in this case, where here mu naught by 4 pi, right, no doubt current is there, dl is equals to this is called the current element. The current element, what I am taking, dy. Therefore dl is equals to, what do you say, that is dy. And this current element, and this is the point P, the line joining, this is the line. Now this line is making an angle theta with respect to, right, current element. Therefore here is also theta is equals to how much? Theta. Substitute here. Now what is the distance? R square. What is the distance? R square. Let us consider this is called a distance R. Let us consider this is the distance R. Now here B is equals to, right, integration of, that is mu naught by 4 pi into I, the current, and dl is equals to, what to say, dy. dl is equals to, what to say, dy, and sin theta is equals to, what to say, same theta, by, what to say, next I will say r square. Now answer must be in the terms of alpha, beta and the d. Now suppose r value is given, suppose theta value is given, substitute here, you will get the answer. But here, what is the r value, what is the theta value, he won't give. He gave here, this is the alpha and this is the beta, right? Therefore b must be in the terms of, that is I, d and alpha and beta, alpha and beta, right? Magnetic field induction at a particular point P in the terms of I, D, alpha, beta. Now, by applying Biot-Savart's law, what is the current? I. This is called current element. Now, what is the current element here? dy. Now, what is the theta? Sin theta. Now, the current element and the point P, the line joining between these two, right? Now this line is making an angle with respect to current element is theta, that is theta is substituted. Now the current element and the point P, which are at a distance of r, r is substituted like this. Now here in this case, from the triangle, let us consider this angle is called, what to say, phi. This angle is called phi. Now from this point O, that is, this is called O. Now this is called, what to say, let us consider y. From the point O, this current element is at a distance of y. What is the thickness of the current element? dy. Now dy is at a distance of r. Now from the diagram, right, from the diagram, from figure, right, from the figure, right, now this is called a perpendicular. Tan phi is equals to, or otherwise, that is tan phi is equals to opposite side by, what to say, adjacent side. This is the perpendicular triangle. Now this is my angle. Opposite side is like this. This will as hypotenuse. This is the adjacent side. Therefore tan phi is equals to opposite side by adjacent side. Right, opposite side, that is y by, what to say, d. That implies y is equals to d tan phi. Now and again from the diagram. Now this is called y,